Okay, everyone, we're going to talk about nerve impingement in the spine and whatever else I'm going to call this. I couldn't figure out what to call this tutorial, but I'm going to answer the what questions. What nerve root levels affected by an intervertebral disc herniation in the cervical, thoracic, and lumbar spine? And what nerve root levels affected by like something like a bone spur in the neural foramina of the CTNL spine? Hello, everyone. My name is Dr. Morton, and I'm the noted anatomist. So starting in the cervical region, cervical nerves exit superior to their associated vertebra. So there is the C1 vertebra, there's the C1 nerve. C2 vertebra, C2 nerve. C3 vertebra, C3 nerve. C4, and so on. And intervertebral discs are named for the supra and infra adjacent vertebrae. And so there's C3 vertebra and C4 vertebra. So the disc in between is C3 and C4 intervertebral disc. Cervical intervertebral disc herniations impinge the nerve in the associated neural foramen. So there's an intervertebral disc, there's the nerve, and we see that the herniation, then the herniated disc is hitting the nerve in the neural foramen. And remember that the nerve in the neural foramen is associated with the infra-adjacent vertebra. In other words, there's C3 and C4 vertebrae, and there's a C3-4 intervertebral disc. So if impinge a nerve, it's that nerve in between, and it's the C4 nerve. And another way of saying it is cervical nerves exit superior to their associated vertebra. Okay. Another thing is anything pushing into the neural foramen, whether it's a herniated disc, a bone spur, a tumor, or whatnot, affect the nerve in that foramen in the cervical region. Okay, so for the thoracic region, thoracic herniated discs are rare, so I'm not going to talk about it. And bone spurs or tumors or whatnot in the neural foramina affect the nerve roots the same as in the lumbar region. So I'm just going to punt to that lumbar region, and we'll talk about it now. Lumbar nerves exit inferior to their associated vertebra. So there's L3 vertebra, L3 nerve. L4 vertebra, L4 nerve. L5, L5. And the intervertebral discs are named for the supra and infra adjacent vertebrae, just like the entire vertebral column. So right there is between the L3, L4 vertebrae, L4 intervertebral disc, L4, L5, L5S1, and such. Most intervertebral disc herniations in the lumbar region occur between L4 and L5 and L5 and S1, and most of them herniate posteriorly. There's some that do laterally, but we're just not going to consider it. And so watch that. You see that herniation, that disc is going posteriorly. You see that? What nerve root is most likely affected? And the answer is lumbar intervertebral disc herniations usually impinge the nerve level associated with the infra-adjacent vertebra. So L4, L5 herniated disc impinges the L5 nerve root because the L4 nerve root exited above the herniation. There's L4. You see it coursing in that neural foramen, but it's above this herniation, which is pushing on the L5 nerve root. And so another way showing you see here is the herniations are associated with the infra-adjacent vertebra. So if that's the L4, L5 intervertebral disc, let's take a look at L5. Take a look at that. You see that? L5 nerve root is the one that's getting impinged in this anterior lateral view. Now, a bone spur or tumor or whatnot that's compressing in the neural foramen compresses the nerve root in that opening. So there is the L4 neural foramen, the one below the L4 vertebra. It's hitting the L4 nerve. Okay, let's do some practice questions. Identify the nerve root most likely affected if the following intervertebral disc were to herniate posteriorly. Well, there's our intervertebral disc. Pause and answer this on your own. When you're ready, press play. I'm continuing. There's the S1 vertebra, there's the L5 vertebra, which means that's the L5-S1 intervertebral disc herniation. And a lumbar intervertebral disc herniation usually impinges the nerve level associated with the infra-adjacent vertebra. In this case, it's S1. Let's see if we're right. So there is the L5 nerve root coming down below the L5 pedicle, and there's the S1 nerve root coming down. That's the one that's going to be hit. Another question. Identify the nerve root most likely affected if the following intervertebral disc were to herniate. Okay, press pause. I'm going to answer now. Well, press pause. You answer it, and I'm going to continue. When you press play, you'll get what I'm saying. I don't know why I'm blabbing like this. There in the dotted line is the base of the skull. There's the first cervical vertebra, and C1, C2, C3, C4, 5, 6, and C7, which means that's a C6, C7 intervertebral disc. And cervical intervertebral disc herniations impinge the nerve within that neural foramen. So which foramen is that? Well, it's the one between C6 and C7, which is the C7 root that's being affected or impinged in this patient. Another question. A bone spur compresses the nerve within the following neural foramen. Identify the nerve root most likely affected. Well, there's the sacrum, which means that's S1, and that's L5, L4, which means it's the L4, L5 neural foramen. And anything within a lumbar neural foramen compresses the nerve in that opening. And what nerve is it? It's the L4 nerve is what's coming out of that. So in review, impingement in the neural foramen in the lumbar region affects the nerve in that foramen. Shing, like that. It's the L4 nerve root. And so if we look at the L4, L5 pedicles with the L4, L5 neural foramen, it's the L4 nerve that would be impinged. But intervertebral disc herniations in the lumbar region usually impinge the nerve level associated with the infra-adjacent vertebra, like that. So if we see the L4, L5 vertebrae, and there's the L4, L5 intervertebral disc, and there's the L4 nerve, and then there's the L5 nerve, watch this, what happens here. Do you see how when that disc herniates, it does not affect L4 because it exited above the herniation, but it hits the L5 nerve root. In other words, the lumbar intervertebral herniation affects the infra-adjacent level. Now in the cervical region, impingement in the neural foramen by a bone spur or an intervertebral disc herniation affects the nerve in that foramen, C5 and C6, and there's a C5, C6 intervertebral disc, and there's the C6 nerve coming above its associated vertebra. And let's zoom in on that and watch what happens with this bone spur. You see that bone spur? It's going to affect the nerve in that foramen, or a herniated disc. You see that? It's going to affect the nerve root in that foramen. So that, my friends, is showing spine nerve impingement in a nutshell.